Let me show you a few examples on how we can apply these to create linear filters. This is my original image. I'm just showing a small 64 by 64, and I hope you can see this in detail. Let's take this original image, and we're going to apply a bunch of filters to it. Let's apply a simple kernel here, just a simple, again, an identity. What do you expect the output to be? Next one we can apply where there is not just the identity, but now we have shifted this by one. What should the output be? Here, of course, we've seen this kind of stuff before, just the average. We can guesstimate as to what the output would be, what the output should be for that one. So for this one, as we've looked at before, it should be the same image again. We haven't actually done anything, right? But just doing a convolution. With doing this, basically, we'll see that the image is shifted by one. Basically, what we've done is kind of given a shift to the image. This one we've seen many a times, and again, applying a convolution with this one will give us a box blur or an average blur. Let's look at another example. And this will give us examples of how we can combine filters. Again, my original image. And this time around, I have two different kernels. I want to take this kernel multiplied by two, which basically is one. Now, basically, it's saying is that I'm going to now try to give it a little bit more strength at the value itself. But then after that, I want to subtract it by an average. So I can do this process. Remember, the properties of convolution allows me to do something before I apply it to the image. I can actually do this process individually. And this would be my new kernel, right? I mean, twice 1, subtracted by 1 over 9, 1.9. And this basically becomes, and this is what my height field of this kernel looks like. Applying this, any guesses what would the output be? In essence, by doing this, we've created a simple sharpening filter. What we've done is basically allowed it to actually create much more resolution information at the peak and remove it further as you go down. So in essence, this raised the information, then we subtracted by the average, and the output is a simple sharpening filter. So by doing these kinds of combinations, we can actually generate a lot of different types of things, and we will, trust me, get into a whole lot of these types of filters. And for those of you who are now started playing around with your different types of development platforms, please remember, you can actually do this in MATLAB, OpenCV, Python, or filtering, or any types of tools that you've been playing around with this. And we will be doing assignments on this too.